RapiCover lets you mark your code as covered by analysis by using justifications. This reduces the effort needed to fully cover your code, and as RapiCover justifications are qualifiable, you can use them in DO-178C or ISO 26262 projects. This RapiCover report includes coverage results from tests and already includes some justifications. Within RapiCover reports, justifications are clearly marked as such, as they're highlighted in blue. We can see a full list of justifications on the Justifications tab of the report. You can zoom in to show results for specific files using RapiCover's Report Navigator. We can see that there are a few justifications for this file. Let's look at our statement coverage for the file. We can see that, while this file has high coverage, not all statements in it are covered. Let's filter out results so we only see the statements that aren't addressed, meaning covered by either tests or justifications. The statement on line 536 in this function hasn't been covered. We can look at the code to see why. The statement is defensive code and shouldn't be reached during normal operation, so we can justify it as untestable. You can create and apply templates when justifying your code. We've already added a template for justifications of defensive code to the project, so let's use this. You can also create custom fields to use in your justifications. This project includes two custom fields, rationale and requirements. We set up our template to automatically fill in the rationale field when we use it. Let's also list the low-level requirement for this statement. When I add the justification, my coverage automatically updates. You can apply justifications to multiple locations, so it's easier to manage them. Other areas of this code are also defensive, so let's apply the justification we just added there. Justifications are stored in a shared library, so you can have multiple users applying justifications at once. If you check your justifications into your revision control system, you can ensure that everyone's coverage will remain up to date so your engineers don't need to spend extra time analyzing the same coverage shortfalls. When your source code changes, RapiCover will help you to migrate justifications between the revisions. Let's see this in action. This report is from the same project and has some code changes, so it includes justifications that need migrating. RapiCover analyzes the impact of code changes and supports your review process. Let's filter the justifications to just show those that need review. In some cases, such as when the file containing a coverage element has not changed, RapiCover can automatically migrate justifications for you, and this is a qualifiable feature, so you can use it in DO-178C and ISO 26262 projects. RapiCover helps your review and migration effort, identifying the impact of the code change with a migration warning value. A value of 4, for example, shows that the structure of the function has changed. RapiCover identifies potential locations for you to migrate justifications after review. After reviewing the code change, we can migrate the justification. After migrating a justification, it is removed from the warning list. Here's a justification from a coverage element in a function that wasn't changed. There's less chance that this change has an impact on the validity of the justification, so the migration value is higher at 6. As the function hasn't changed, RapiCover identifies the statement that has been justified, even if the line number has changed due to other changes in the file. You can configure the strictness with which this auto-migration can take place. By default, RapiCover is strict, only migrating justifications automatically when the file hasn't changed. You can easily make this less strict, so justifications will automatically migrate when the function is unchanged.